How do you feel you went out there?
Yeah, look, it was a bit of a mystery, really. I mean, I got off to a great start. I was very happy with my entry. My turns were good. Couldn't fault my technique. Everything was perfect. And yet I came last, and by a very long way, too. So, yeah, I really don't know. I mean, I guess if I was to pick one thing, maybe I could say it was the chicken suit slowed me down, but I really don't know. I think I'm just clutching at straws here. Thank you.
You will not be marrying that Irish fool you've been seeing.
What if I love him?
That in itself is not a good enough reason.
Stand and deliver.
Good afternoon, sir, me lady. We'll be relieving you of your money and jewellery now, if you'll be so kind.
Or what, you cowards?
Or you'll get a taste of our colonial bush band music.
Wait, wait! All right, you've made your point.
Be off with you then. Yeah!
Ah, we've done well, lads.
A Roy's fat cat, he must have been.
Aye, we have done well indeed. I think it's time for a tune, lads.
Ooh, nice one, Tommy.
And now, if there are any questions.
What's the fish of the day?
It's a rainbow trout. It's oven-baked in a white wine and garlic sauce, sprinkled with sea salt, and rested on a Solerac and Pontiac mash. Then it's served with a salad of rocket and cherry tomatoes that's drizzled with balsamic in an individual porcelain bowl. Mm-hmm.
Excuse me, where would I find the bathroom?
Just over there. First, you stand up and walk over there. The door is open, the fly is unzipped, then the penis is taken out and rested in the hand. Finally, the bladder is empty, with the urine carefully drizzled in an individual porcelain bowl.
Sarah? In here. Gratham thought you might need a hand.
Yeah, well, he's right. It's a real mess.
Walk me through it. What do we got?
Well, there's blood spatter on the table. Looks like someone's tried to clean it off with, I guess, bleach.
And the bed?
We got hairs, fibers, body fluids.
Uh-huh.
Over here, we got a broken lamp that used to be in the shape of a shepherdess. And check this out.
No Bible in the nightstand. Interesting. You got any theories yet?
Yeah. I think a Brazilian animal smuggler was keeping a spider monkey called Bob in the bathroom. Bob escaped and was having violent sex with a shepherdess-shaped lamp when the smuggler walked in and beat him to death with the Gideon's Bible.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Just one thing, how do you know the smuggler was from Brazil?
Found his passport on the bathroom floor.
Good job. Well, we better get to work. I'll do the beds, you do the bathroom, and hurry too. We gotta get this whole floor done by check-in.
Oh, I hate doing the bathroom.
Seaman Parr was a man we trusted, a man we laughed with, a man we loved better than a brother. And so, Lord, it is with a heavy heart that we commit his body to the sea, where it will rest in peace and with dignity for all eternity. Amen.
Oh, gee, looks like we got a bite, sir!
You little ripper.
I think it's a marlin!
And a big one, too!
Thank you, Pyle.
One, two.
Sorry, ma'am. Wrong house.
Police! Police!
What are you doing?
Sorry, guys. Wrong house.
Police!
On the ground, mate. On the ground now. Dropping there.
What the hell are you doing?
Sorry, sir. Wrong house.
Well, that's his street done.
And this one's for you.
Pleasure as always.
Okay, brownies, time for some more survival skills. Now, this week, Susie and I are going to teach you how one girl can be secret twins. Okay, now look at Susie here. She seems like she's one girl, but she is actually two very different people.
That's right. When I meet a guy at a party, I'm casual fun Susie.
Yeah, now, casual fun Susie is totally into good times and living for the moment and casual sex.
Woohoo! Let's go crazy!
But when the guy wakes up in the morning, her twin appears. Let's get married, Susie.
I'm so glad we found each other.
See? Same girl, two totally different personalities. Secret twins. Now, a lot of guys have encountered girls who appear different in the morning. The guy will then try to make out that this was just a casual thing. That's when we use one of our guaranteed answer questions. Okay, now, for the purposes of this demonstration, I'll be playing Susie's latest one-night stand, Ben.
Oh, I thought last night was wonderful.
Yeah, it was fun. Look, I better get going.
Well, so what am I? Just another one of your whores?
The guaranteed answer question?
Ben has no choice. He must say no.
Oh, no.
So then am I your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Snap! The trap shuts. Another unwilling man, Marlon, is hooked into a long-term relationship. Okay, brownies, that's it for today. We'll see you next week.
And remember, what's the fastest way to a spring wedding?
The phantom pregnancy. I see, Mr. Bond, that you like to play to win.
To me, Herr Blofeld, there is no other way to play.
When the stakes are high, my friend, the wise man knows that it is sometimes better to lose early.
I've always found that it's better to win late.
We shall see. Mr. Bond.
Indeed, we shall. Your call, Blofeld.
All right. Do you have Fireman Frank?
No, I don't. Go fish.
Damn you, Bond. Damn you to hell.
Yes?
Mrs. Babeek.
Where's my baby?
Shut up and listen. I'm only going to say this once. This Friday the 8th to the 5th at 3 o'clock, take the number 10 bus to number 6 7th Avenue. Go to the 4th floor and leave two bags containing $50,000 outside the 9th door along. Knock 5 times and leave. You got that?
Yes.
You made note of it?
No, but the cops are recording it, so I...
There you go, mate. Night, night.
Hey, Dad.
Yes, mate.
Aren't you going to say goodnight to Timmy?
Who's Timmy, mate?
He's my secret friend.
Now, look, mate, what have I told you about that?
That Timmy isn't real?
That's right. Now, I don't want to come down too hard on you, but you're 9 years old, and that's getting a bit too big to have a secret friend. What if other people found out? They might start to think you're a bit weird. So I don't want to hear any more talk about having a secret friend, okay?
Okay, Dad, but...
But what, mate?
But you have a secret friend.
No, mate, I only have real friends. And the sooner you go to sleep like a good boy, the sooner I can pop down the pub to see them.
Now, remember when I came home early and I saw you with that lady? You told me that she was your secret friend.
Did I?
You told me that she wasn't real.
Yes. Yes, I did. And you know what, mate? Forget everything I just said. There's nothing wrong with having a secret friend. In fact, you can have all the secret imaginary friends that you want.
Honest, Dad.
Would I lie to you, mate? So long as you remember that the best thing about having a secret friend is that they stay secret. Yeah, night, night. Oh, and night, night to Timmy, too.
Did you hear that? That was the whistle of the mythical red-crested speckle-backed humming parrot. Did anyone see where it came from?
I think it came from over there.
No, I think it came from over here.
Well, there it is. I can see it, up that tree.
Ah, good work. Now, who best can remember how to prepare red-crested speckle-backed humming?
Very lightly sautéed with fennel, organic garlic and extra virgin olive oil.
Spot on. And always preserve the frond of the fennel for a garnish. Now, I've heard there's an endangered hairy-nosed wallaby around here somewhere.
That sounds nice.
And finally, I think I'd bring more than just my professional experience to Bothroyd and Baker. I'm also dynamic and I genuinely enjoy working as part of a team and I see myself here for the long haul.
All right, Mary. Well, everything seems in order. Just one final question. Do you know shorthand?
No, I'm afraid I don't. Sorry.
No matter. I'll introduce you now. Mr. Shorthand. And Mr. Shorthand, this is Mary. Mary Shorthand.
Mary, nice to meet you. Welcome aboard.
All right. Well, that done. What say we adjourn and head down to the local for a couple of coldies?
Oh, yeah.
Bring your straw, Mr. Shorthand.
I love it here.
G'day, mate. I'd just like to pay for the petrol. God! Sunglasses! Where's your sunglasses?
Over there.
See, I always wondered who bought these.
And a very Merry Christmas, Linnell.
Excuse me. Did you tell my son that Santa was going to bring him a brand new mountain bike for Christmas?
Maybe.
Well, it's not going to happen, and I'd appreciate it if you would tell him the truth.
The truth?
Now.
All right. I'm going to give it to you straight, son. Your parents don't love you enough to buy you a bike.
Thanks. It's always so much easier when it comes from someone else, isn't it? Come on!
We are gathered here today to mark the sad passing of our friend Jeff. I know many of you will be thinking, how is it possible that someone so young, so full of life, should be torn from among us? And while it's important to grieve, it's also important to keep going. Never forgetting the endless possibilities that life still has to offer us. And with that in mind, do we hear an opening bid for Jeff's mountain bike? 20, 20, I'll take 20. Come on, people, chance of a lifetime. 20, thank you very much. 25, do I hear 25? Thank you very much at the back there. 25, sentimental gift, people. Come on, chance of a lifetime here.
What are you doing out there, kid? He's killing you.
Oh, coach, I just can't seem to land a punch.
Get your head screwed on or he's gonna knock you out. Now, remember the strategy?
I remember. Sing like a butterfly, flow like a bee.
No, kid, no, it's the other way round.
Who's next?
What have you got for a dollar?
A dollar? Apples? Homemade health bars?
I was after something a bit harder.
Who's asking?
Danny.
Don't know any Danny.
Danny. Oh, I'm a friend of Wesley's.
Dollar gets you two mint patties and a stash of raspberry bullets. Unless you want something stiffer.
What do you got?
Caramel buds.
Caramel.
All right, whiz-fizz. Don't eat any of it until you're well out of here. I don't want any sugar ODs on my turf, all right? Have you got any friends you want to bring to me? Give them these. Don't wave it around, Jesus. Now give me some hard earned. Pump the stump. Give me some skin. Oh, I'm with the gummy bears. We never met.
I need more chalk. And we've just witnessed another superb piece of golf.
Yes, look, I've been impressed the whole tournament.
The way Ian Smith held that flag. What a caddy.
Such a firm, steady hand. I just love the way he moves.
And really, his knowledge of the course...
unparalleled. And what an exceptional choice of clubs he's made.
What? Oh, yeah, all right. We're also being asked to mention that, what's her name? Sorensen, Sorkinson, Sorkin, look, I don't know. She's just won her 12th consecutive world title.
And doesn't she look great in those trousers?
Yeah, nice butt, great rack too. But back with more of caddy Ian Smith after this.
Welcome, everyone, to this divorced dad's support meeting. My name's Simon. Now, I'd like everyone to feel completely comfortable with saying whatever's on their mind, OK? So who'd like to go first? Yeah?
My name's Michael. I've been divorced for a year. I've got two sons. One's 11, one's 9. They live with their mother. It's just that I...
Go on, Michael.
I guess I find it hard meeting the expectations society has of a divorced dad. I mean, when I have the kids on the weekend, I don't bag out their mum. You know, I know I should be putting them in the middle of us, but I just can't help myself. You know, I know I need to have the kids back by 5 o'clock on a Sunday with their mother and... Oh, I'm sorry. I know this sounds bad, but I'm always on time. I've tried to be unreliable, you know, but something always comes up and there I am, like clockwork. You know, she's got a new man in her life now and I just don't see him as a threat to my relationship with my sons at all. I just don't understand why I can't be like all the other divorced dads.
Thank you, Michael. These are obviously some very serious problems that you're facing.
And the worst thing is, I have never turned up to her house drunk and demanded to see the kids.
Sorry, Michael, I think you might need more specialist care than this group can provide. Freak. Hey, Johnny.
Hey.
Nice uniform. For a girl.
Can you get out of the way, please? I have to go.
Oh, no. I'm not moving. What are you gonna do? Hit me with your handbag.
Gotta work on those spares.
So, which one is she?
She's over there.
The blonde?
No, the brunette.
Nice. What does she do?
She's a lawyer.
Smart then. Good sense of humour?
Yep.
I like that in a woman, good sense of humour. Can she cook?
Yeah, she's a really good cook.
I like a woman that can cook. Show she cares. What about,
What?
You know.
Come on, mate, a gentleman never tells. She's good.
Sounds perfect.
Yeah, she is.
Hey, thanks again for thinking of me. Really appreciate it.
No worries. So, can you kill her for me?
Sure.
Great. How much?
Classy girl like that? 5,000?
Done.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
It's a longer flight to Australia, hmm?
Yes.
Many hours. Hours, yes?
Hours.
Hours, yes. I'm hope we can speak this time. Hours, yes? So I'm learn that good English. I'm hope many hours we speak English so I can learn good English when we arrive.
Arrive.
Arrive. when we have many hours English, I speak English good like you make.
Look, many do you want me to teach you some English?
Please.
Okay. Now, repeat after me. Mm-hmm. Please bring...
Please bring...
Hi, honey. Looking for a good time?
Yeah.
Try Bowlerama. They've got a special on. 2-game shoe hire and a Coke for just $20.
Thanks a lot.
Anytime.
You call for a steward, sir?
Please bring me captain. For I have explosive thing in my baggage and I would like to be tonight.
If you could just wait here one minute.
Mrs. Brinkman, I'm sorry, I have some bad news. I've examined these very carefully, and I have to say, I still don't fancy you in the slightest.
No!
I'm sorry.
But I got these done especially for you!
Sorry.
Please, do not punish him, Boris, for bad English! I'm